Hey, thanks so much for finding the video. Do us a favor. If you haven't done so yet, please subscribe. And be sure to leave your comment. We love to interact. Enjoy the video. All right, so let's start with maybe some pretty obvious big picture ones. Were you surprised, or what was your reaction when you heard the Saints took Payton Turner 28th?
Well, I wasn't terribly surprised, not necessarily from the Saints' perspective, but just from Payton going in the first round, just for the simple fact that in the last week, last few days, there had been a lot of buzz about Turner being a potential late first-round pick. The reason being is that this draft has not been terribly deep on defensive linemen. You know, we got 18 picks last night before we saw one come off the board, and I ended up trying to research and see when was the last time that we went this far in the draft without a defensive lineman being drafted, and it's been at least 30, 40 years. Wow. I couldn't even actually end up getting that answer. But that said, is pass rushers are always at a premium in football, whether it's high school football, college football, NFL, and Payton Turner can do that. He's a tremendous asset as a pass rusher. He's obviously an edge rusher, most likely in the NFL, but he can play multiple positions. And his pro day was fantastic. And he checks off a lot of boxes from a leadership standpoint, a character standpoint. And he's got the size and athleticism that you want. So all the things that you look for as an NFL scout, he pretty much checks all those boxes.
So what caused him to sort – and correct me if I'm wrong, but it seems like with the pro day and everything, his stock elevated of late. What was it about him that caused the stock to rise?
I think it was, one, his performance at pro day, two, how well he interviews, and the raves that he got from coaches, teammates, everybody that's been around him. I mean, from the time even that he was recruited at Houston, when he was a two-star kid coming out of Westside High, he was a long, lanky kid, 6'5", 220 as a recruit, really developed his body and took to the game right away to learn how to play along the defensive line. He was really raw as a high school prospect. So he had to develop all his pass rush skills while he was at Houston. And he did a really good job with that. And again, became a big time leader on the team. So you couple that, all the character traits that are huge, and then the pro day performance that was really strong. He had good vertical. He could, you know, runs really well. His three cone time was really good. His short shuttle time was good for his position. So all those things, you look at that and you look at the versatility that he's a guy that can play on the edge. He can stand up. He can put his hand in the dirt. All those things add up to a guy that looks like a promising prospect that you can plug and play.
Is he a guy that has been mostly durable during his time in college?
That has been the challenge. So last year he did get banged up a little bit. He missed 3 of the 8 games that Houston played. He was tremendously productive in the 5 they did play, but he did miss a few. And then his junior year, he had to play with, I think it was 4 broken or dislocated fingers. Now, he did not miss games for that. He played through them, but he was certainly played through banged up, and it affected his production. But yeah, he definitely has had some injuries in his past. He also had an ACL injury as a high school senior. So he does have some injuries in his past, but for the most part, with the exception of the end of his senior year, he has been able to see the field pretty consistently.
Sam Kahn Jr. is our guest of The Athletic, talking about Payton Turner, the Saints' first-round draft pick. The Saints, maybe more than any team that I've covered, value culture so much. Look, after their back-to-back-to-back 7-9 seasons, they really cleaned house and got rid of a lot of veteran players who weren't bought in, even productive veteran players. A lot of people are raving about the press conference last night that Payton Turner gave after he was picked. What can you tell us about Payton Turner, the person, the young man?
He's known as a really sense of humor. He's got a great sense of humor, very likable, got along with his teammates really well, and also was a leader. I talked to Doug Belk, the defensive coordinator at Houston, yesterday, and he said he's a leader, not a follower. Guys noticed when he talked, and they paid attention to what he said, and he was an example for other guys in his room and across the team. Not likable kid off the field, funny, intelligent, and works hard. He does not take plays off. If you watch his video, the guy plays hard. The play that Belk told me that was his favorite play of Turner's at Houston was last year when they played BYU. He was chasing Zach Wilson, and Zach dumps off a pass to the fullback. Fullback goes 20 yards downfield. Turner was about 5 yards behind him and chased him down and caught up. By the time the fullback hits the turf, Turner was right there getting in on the tackle. And that's the kind of effort that he gives on every play, and I think that won a lot of people over, both at Houston and in the NFL scout circle.
Can he play inside as well as outside?
He can. He absolutely can. He actually did a little bit at Houston. I think it was his junior year, he bulked up, or sophomore year, he bulked up to about 280, 285, even close to 290, and played a lot inside. So he can do that. He can play the three technique and get his hand down. But I think his best fit long-term in the NFL is probably on the edge.
Sam Kahn Jr., what type of player, person, what else would you say to Saints fans who are obviously saw this pick and maybe a little concerned that it's a player they don't know a ton about the type of guy and player they're getting?
I think when you look at draft prospects, I think the important thing is not look at where they played or whether and where they were mocked, placed on a mock draft, is what kind of traits do they have? And I think that we find that in recruiting. I cover mostly college football, and you see guys are looking for elite traits. Do they have the size? Do they have the athleticism? Do they have the personality and the character traits that you want? If you check all those boxes off, then you have got won half the battle, in my opinion. Because the thing is can you play A, which we know he can do, and he's a tremendous producer. Like I said, five games last year, 5 sacks, 10.5 sacks off the loss. Plenty of production for the time that he played. Then the off-the-field stuff, you see there's no red flags in his background in that regard. So that means that you're going to be able to rely on that guy. And the other question is does a guy play hard, which he does all the time? So I think when you put all those things together, that makes for a pretty solid prospect. And those are the types of things that make a guy like Payton, who maybe was a third-round guy at one point or a late second-round guy, shoot up the board, because you start comparing to other guys who do have some flaws or some red flags, then it kind of moves him up because he compares favorably in that regard.
Do you have an NFL comp, a player he maybe reminds you of?
I do not. I'm not an NFL scout, so I can't say that. But I think he was a tremendous kid. I'll tell you what, he's the other thing to know about him in his background is he was a two-sport star in high school. He played a lot of basketball, and he actually was recruited as a basketball prospect also before he signed with Houston. That ended up going by the wayside after he tore his knee up because he didn't get to play senior year of high school. But he's got some athleticism to him just because he was a multi-sport star in his background.
Sam Kahn of The Athletic shedding some light on the Saints' first-round draft pick, Payton Turner. Appreciate you jumping aboard today, man. Thanks for the time.
No problem. Thanks for having me.
Hey, thanks so much for watching. Please leave your comments. I love to interact. And be sure to hit the red subscribe button below.